today we're going to change the bike. Flat tire. Only flat on bottom, but, you know, flat around. We're going to change it and go from there. So. Okay, it's got the quick release on these, which is nice. I'll show you right here what I'm talking about the quick release. Here it's a quick release. And undo that one. And there we go. Bike tire's loose. Also, I spun a tire one day. I put one on and I spun it. I caught my fingernail. Ripped it right off. So it was just hanging on a piece of skin, so I went to the ER and they took the rest of the fingernail off. It took about 2 months. It grew back, yeah, to pretty good. Not like it was. So just grab the wheel, grab the gears up here at the top. Well, first you gotta get her loosened up here. Pull it right out of there. Pull it back out of the way so you don't scratch anything out. Get it. A lot of times you'll need a spoon. Well, I lost my spoon. Bike spoon, yeah. I call them spoons, you just pop them in like this. Never use a spoon to put the tire back on. More likely you will get it. You might pinch the new tube or freshly patched it. You look and see which way the tire tread goes. And you put the spoon in there, take right off here. And go off and lay it down just like this is. And then when you get this off, you should get a rag or something that you can find where the hole is. Could be something sticking through here, so you always want to go around the inside. Take a rag or a hand with a glove on it and look for something sticking through. A nail, screw, sticker. We got a lot of thorns out here. Ah, I think I found it. Yes. That's what it was, right there. That little sticker there, but you can't see. That poked through. Yeah, there's a little hole there. Take it out. That's probably what poked the hole in the screen, in the tube. We're going to go all the way around here. Now when I replace the tires, I'll go with the Kevlar tires, a little bit stronger. So, just run right back here. Right here, so when I put it back on the hot load, put it back together. Should have been the right way. Tire on there like this, one side. These are actually easy tires to put on, whatever. Well, it's quite squeezy. Then you find a hole where the everything go through. Get up right here. Put it through there. I can do it with your layer there. Way easier to do that. Shouldn't take you very long, but he's on it. But I'm just going slow. Okay, that's how you change a tube. 35 to 65. Wow, that's pretty good. 5 pounds. I'm on the road, I carry CO2 cartridges. A little thing here, so you don't have to pump them up. You have to change them, just hook these right on there. The air has to come through here. CO2 cartridges. These are all our bikes. Okay. This lined up into the disc, all lined up. Okay, good. I'm gonna show you something else that a lot of times people don't tell you. But you tighten these up on all bikes. Some people have them down, aiming down. Well, if you're riding along, especially on a mountain bike, and bump something, that could open it up for your tire. But you should always have them aiming up out of the way. There you go. I'd like to add one more thing. Well, two more things. Always wear bike helmet. Always lock your bikes up, because no matter where you're at, I've heard of people getting their bikes stolen. On the track.